Opportunity with education?
No, boys are favored in our community because the boys are, they don't usually do a lot of job at home or even going to school, they go early than us because where we remain at home, for example, we milk cows in the morning and even we cook for them tea instead of them cooking for themselves. And also when the circumcision ceremonies are arranged, the boys are allowed to go back to school while the girls, they just remain at home and they get married.
Yeah. So you're the first girl in your family to go to secondary school, is that right?
Yes.
What made you choose a different path than your parents?
I just wanted to choose a different path because many girls in our family, they were circumcised and then they were married. But they just get married for, not for full years, but they still come back with their kids. And then now they depend on my father, and my father also has a family. So they are bringing another burden to my father. Because they are not educated, when their husbands tell them to go, they no longer want them, they just come home with their kids. Because then if you are educated, you get your own job and even you are respected. So you can take care of yourself and even your children. So because they are not educated, they are not able to take care of themselves. And me, I want to take care of myself, and even I know that the time I'll be maybe 25, or I know my parents will be old, so I want to take care of them.
Who inspired you in your life to be so independent and to make your own choices like this?
When I was in primary, I used to love my teachers. So I used to spend my time, maybe, and also I was a class prefect in primary, so I used to spend most of my time with my teachers. So when I take books for them to mark, they'll ask me about what's going on. Then I tell them that maybe, for example, my father wants me to be circumcised. So they tell me that, don't do that because it will affect you. So I wanted also to study so that I can depend on myself like them.
So most Maasai girls your age, like you said, are getting circumcised and then married. How did you avoid these pressures?
Yeah, it was just they organized for me to be circumcised, but I rejected it. It was just on 4th December 2007 when I was in Form 1. And then my father decided to organize a ceremony for me to be circumcised, but I rejected it. So on the process of rejecting it, my friends refused me, and even other family members, they never wanted again to associate with me. So when my friends rejected me and even the family members, I remained alone, and the only business I had is with my books. And after books, I went to sleep. I had nobody to, only my brothers I could talk to and my mother. And then one day my father, he told me that he's sorry, he's not going to tell me to be circumcised again. Then I forgave him. Then now we're just living in harmony.
You changed their minds about circumcising you.
I refuse it because I've witnessed many girls being circumcised in this area, and no girl have ever stood for the right of girls not being circumcised. So I said that I'll set an history for them because it really takes a lot for a girl to be circumcised. They usually bleed and they feel a lot of pain, and you will even bleed for 1 week, not just days, but 1 week. So I never wanted to experience such things because I've done nothing wrong to be forced to experience such things.
And are your friends talking with you again, or are they still upset about your choice?
Yeah, they have come back to me, and I can even advise them because they have seen that I've made the right choice, and even now they respect me.
How did you meet Kakenya for the first time?
Because she's now a neighbor. I saw her when I was passing, then I went and greeted her. But from the story I'm hearing from people, how she grew up and the experience she had. So also say if Kakenya have passed through those all, and now she's able to stand other girls and tell other girls not to be circumcised, why not me? Because as they say that experience is the best teacher, I am not waiting to experience what you have experienced. I've seen and I've heard it, so it's enough for me to change our community.
When you finish secondary school, what happens next?
I like to go to the university.
And what do you want to study at the university?
I like to be a surgeon because, for example, when our parents are taken to the hospital, some of them have not gone to school and they don't know how to talk in English or Kiswahili. So I like to be a surgeon. For example, when they are brought to the hospital, I can talk to them with mother tongue and ask them their problems and understand them more, and I think I can save their life. And also, I like the hospitals to be brought near because usually we use a lot of money taking maybe our parents or even children or our people to Nairobi, all the way to Nairobi, so that they can be helped. So I like it to be near so that they can just use a little money.
And have you witnessed a situation before when someone was very sick and they needed a doctor but they were too far away?
Yes, I witnessed. Just last year my father was sick and he was to be taken for an operation, but he lacked even, it takes a lot of money for him to be operated. So it forced even our family to arrange for a fundraising for him to be operated. And also, he was very sick that day when I came to school, I just found him fainted and lying on the ground. So I wished if I was just a doctor, I could have done it just here and not taking my father for a long distance up all the way to Nairobi to be operated. And they really used a lot of money, and I wished if I was just educated and a surgeon who can just operate my father and they get well.
So when you're a doctor, things will be different.
Yes.
Oh,